Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surabhi Sharma. The top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 21st of November. India's environment minister says air plan developed to combat Delhi pollution. Newly appointed ministers take charge in Nepal after cabinet reshuffle. And Mahinda Rajapaksa sworn in as Sri Lanka's new Prime Minister. And now for all the details. Air quality in Indian capital New Delhi slipped into hazardous category on Thursday due to calm winds as most of the residents spoke to a thick smog. Environment Minister Prakash Javadekar, speaking in the upper house of the parliament, said the government has initiated several steps to abate and control air pollution.
A thick blanket of smoke wrapped the Indian capital New Delhi and National Capital Region once again as the air quality deteriorated further, reaching to hazardous category on Thursday. Though the smoke receded in the past few days and air quality had improved, on Thursday, as the wind speed dropped, smoke reappeared and plummeted air pollution levels. Meanwhile, the winter session of the Indian Parliament, which entered its fourth day, was action-packed and debate over the hazardous level of pollution in the national capital was held. Environment Minister Prakash Javadekar, speaking in the upper house of the parliament, said the government is serious about the Delhi air pollution issue and has initiated several steps to address it.
A comprehensive air plan for Delhi NCR has been developed, identifying the timelines and implementing agencies for actions delineated. The central government has notified a graded response action plan for Delhi and NCR for different levels of pollution.
Javadekar informed the parliament that a high-level task force was constituted under the chairmanship of Principal Secretary to the Prime Minister in order to abate and control air pollution. Every year at this time, other than the smoke triggered by firecrackers, smoke from surrounding countryside where farmers burn the crop residue in their fields to prepare for winter sowing causes pollution in New Delhi and surrounding cities.
U.S. Congressman Pete Olson has lauded India for abrogating Article 370, which granted special status to Jammu and Kashmir. Olson said for 70 years, the scrapped provision forced people of the erstwhile state to live under different laws than other Indians.
U.S. Congressman Pete Olson has praised India for revoking Article 370, which granted special status to Jammu and Kashmir, saying the move will bring equality and peace to the region. Speaking in the U.S. House of Representatives, Olson said that Article 370 was a temporary provision, a stopgap measure that was forcing the people of Jammu and Kashmir to live under laws different from the rest of India. Olson also tweeted his speech and said he spoke to stand with Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi as he works to bring peace to the region, expand democracy, and unite the people of Jammu and Kashmir with the greater Indian community.
Earlier this year, the Indian Parliament confirmed that Article 370's temporary status should end. It ended. It gave the people of Jammu and Kashmir the same rights as all Indians. It was a landslide, 125-61 in the Raja Sabha and 370-70 in the Lok Sabha. This action puts equality for all Indians.
India's decision to revoke Article 370 from Jammu and Kashmir on August 5 has been hailed internationally, with several countries calling the move as India's internal matter, even as Pakistan has been trying to internationalize the issue. Islamabad has found itself isolated after being snubbed at several platforms, including the United Nations, as well as by countries like the United States, France and Russia.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz President Shabazz Sharif's resignation from the National Assembly as a Public Accounts Committee Chairman has been accepted by the Speaker. Speaker Asad Qaisar has now summoned the session on November 28th to elect its new chairman.
Speaker of the National Assembly of Pakistan, Asad Qasir, on Wednesday approved the resignation of opposition leader in the National Assembly, Shehbaz Sharif, as the Public Accounts Committee chairman. In his resignation, which Shehbaz submitted on November 18, a day before his departure to London with his brother and former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif, the Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz, or PMLN president, nominated Rana Tanveer Hussain as his replacement. The question now remains is whether the government will accept the nomination or will bring its own candidate for the post. Speaker Asad Qasir has now summoned the session on November 28 to elect its new chairman.
The gruesome condition of roads has become a major concern for the people in the illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan. A protest was held recently by locals to raise their voice over the issue. A protest was held recently by locals in Gilgit-Baltistan over the poor condition of roads in the illegally occupied region. The protesters, including local shopkeepers, blamed that the stooge government working at Islamabad's behest has completely neglected the issue and there has been no provision to construct the dilapidated roads. Shopkeepers said the dust and pollution from the dirty roads has made it difficult for them to stay in their shops and demanded the authorities to act immediately.
रोड की हालत आप देख रहे हैं मट्टी ही मट्टी है ना कोई पानी डालता है ना कोई पक्के कर रही है सारे लगे बाहर इधर काम कोई नहीं कर रहा है इस वजह से एहतियात की वजह से आज ये रोड बंद किया हुआ है
गवर्नमेंट ने ये जो ठेकेदार को तीन टाइम का पानी का है सुबह दोपहर शाम पानी डालो और इनका कोई खर्चा नहीं है दरिया से पानी लाना पड़ता है दस मिनट लगता है वो भी नहीं डाल रहे दादा देखो ना दुकानदारों की हालत देखो क्या है सारे सब
Gilgit-Baltistan is home to some of the most captivating natural sceneries on earth, and its serene landscape has the potential of making it a tourist hotspot. However, the sad reality is that the number of tourists flocking the region has also declined to a dismal low due to the poor infrastructure. News from Nepal. Nepal's Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli has reshuffled his cabinet, inducting 6 new cabinet ministers and 3 ministers of state. The newly appointed ministers took charge of their roles on Thursday after an oath-taking ceremony at the Presidential Palace in Kathmandu.
Six new cabinet ministers and 3 ministers of state in Nepal took charge of their roles on Thursday, a day after the cabinet reshuffle in the country. President Bidya Devi Bhandari administered the oath of office in secrecy to the 6 cabinet ministers, while Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli administered the oath to the newly appointed ministers of state. A meeting of the ruling Nepal Communist Party or NCP on Wednesday finalized the names of the 6 inducted cabinet ministers and 3 ministers of state in place of some outgoing ministers who, according to Prime Minister Oli, had performed underwhelmingly. Oli will continue as the country's premier for the rest of the government's tenure, while co-chair of NCP Pushpa Kamal Dehal will be handling party affairs as the executive head, was also decided during Wednesday's meeting, according to media reports. Earlier, Dehal had demanded that the premiership be shared between the two, as agreed during the unification of their separate parties in 2018, but Oli was denying. Oli took over the Prime Minister's post in 2018 after NCP's landslide victory in the first federal election of the Himalayan nation.
News from Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka's newly elected President Gotabaya Rajapaksa has sworn in his brother and former President Mahinda Rajapaksa as Prime Minister on Thursday. This is the first time in the history of the island nation that 2 siblings are in the positions of President and the Prime Minister.
Sri Lanka's newly elected President Gotabaya Rajapaksa has sworn in his brother and former President Mahinda Rajapaksa as Prime Minister on Thursday. This is the first time in the history of Sri Lanka that 2 siblings are in the positions of President and the Prime Minister. Ranil Wickremesinghe stepped down as Prime Minister earlier on Thursday to clear the way for new President Gotabaya to form his government. Sri Lanka Podujana Perumuna leader Mahinda served as president from 2005 to 2015. He was unable to run again due to a 2015 legislation that disallows a third term. The 2015 legislation or the 19th amendment to Sri Lanka's constitution clips the president's executive powers, in turn empowering the parliament led by the prime minister. Meanwhile, the caretaker government will function until the parliamentary elections in March 2020.
Moving on to news from Bangladesh, a 7-day fair to expand market of products made by marginalized entrepreneurs concluded in Bangladesh on Wednesday. The event showcased a range of agriculture, food and traditional products. A week-long fair to promote products made by marginalized entrepreneurs in Bangladesh concluded in the country's capital, Dhaka, on Wednesday. A total of 130 organizers from across Bangladesh set up 190 stalls and showcased a range of agricultural, food and traditional products during the event. The event was organized by the Palli Karma Sahayak Foundation, a financial institution founded by the government of Bangladesh. The event in Bangabandhu International Conference Center was inaugurated by Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, along with other ministers, parliament members and diplomats on November 14th. The fair was organized with a view of expanding the market of products made by the marginalized people and other participants. A large number of birds belonging to different species have started flocking to the Godavi Bird Sanctuary in southern India ahead of the migratory season. A natural lake and hundreds of trees at the sanctuary are giving shelter to the birds, which is a treat to watch.
A large number of migratory birds belonging to 200 different species were seen flocking around a lake in southern India's Shivamoga city. Eurasian spoonbill, Indian cormorant and pariakide were among the birds that have recently migrated to the Godavi Bird Sanctuary in Shivamoga. A natural lake and hundreds of trees at the sanctuary are giving shelter to the migratory birds. A platform is also built in the sanctuary for bird watchers to have a closer look at the birds.
This bird sanctuary is very old and this is situated next to Godavi Lake. So it's because of the biodiversity and ecodiversity which is next to this Godavi Lake that brings a lot of birds to this particular spot. And as I said, it's just not the local birds which come here, it's the foreign guests which come here.
With the onset of winter, the Siberian birds spread their wings to begin a journey spanning thousands of kilometers. From early November onwards, the migratory birds keep arriving in India till December and return during the spring season.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. India's Environment Minister says air plan developed to combat Delhi pollution. Newly appointed ministers take charge in Nepal after cabinet reshuffle. And Mahinda Rajapaksa sworn in as Sri Lanka's new Prime Minister. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.